guys, when we got in this vehicle a while ago, we had 199 subs. We was just sitting here talking about new video ideas. He got curious, checked our subscriber count. We just hit 200 subs right now. I've been watching the sub count for like 3 days and it hasn't even moved. Well, it changed tonight. It's 200 subs. So we're going to do a new video right now.
Tomorrow.
We're going to be going out and catching some rainbow trout. This is our third. Is it third or fourth?
Fourth.
This is our fourth catch and cook. We're going to be catching some rainbow trout and cooking them up. It's going to be awesome. So here we go. Right here on the lake today, finally hit 200 subs. Right here trying to catch us some trout, do a catch and cook video. I've already had two follow it all the way up to the dock, so I'm guessing it's probably going to be a pretty good day. They're jumping all around here. So we're going to throw a few times here, see if we can't get us one, and cook him up. Got one, Ernie? How big is he? Oh my God. What a stud.
45 pounds all day long.
All day long, baby. He's a good one. We gotta put him back for seed, though.
Oh yeah, he's way too little kid.
Bye-bye.
He gone.
Well, guys, it's set in raining on us here. Ernie's got him another trout here. How many does that make today, Ernie?
That makes my second and your third, I believe.
We've been doing pretty good up here today. We got some on the stringer here. They've been biting pretty good, but we ain't been getting much film because every time we go to film, it starts raining and we don't want to get our crap wet and destroy it. So that's just one more there. And, they should be tasty, shouldn't they, Ernie?
Buddy.
Well, guys, Ernie just landed biggest one I've seen in hand. We let one off a while ago that was a lot bigger than him, but this is the biggest one that we've caught so far, ever, and actually landed it. We just got us another one here. They're biting real good. We'll have our limit here pretty soon, I do believe. I can't wait to put these things on the grill. Okay, these fish here are probably the easiest fish I've ever cleaned before. It don't take long to do one of them. What I do first is I start right here with my knife and I cut. This way where it takes the front two fins off with the head.
And see if it'll cut. It will cut.
After that, what I do is I take my knife and I put it right here. I work him up the belly, get the guts out. These fins right here, you don't really have to cut them. They pull off pretty easy with just your fingers. Sometimes they can be a little tough. You just gotta keep working them there and then you can get them off. Then what I do, this fish here, his fin on his back's kindly chewed off, but you can just go right down it. Saw it off. This fin right here on his back. Turn him over here and cut this fin off. Off tail. And that's pretty much it. Now all you gotta do is take your knife and just get what little bit of the scales you can off. And then he's ready for the grill. Well guys, for the first time we've actually got a professional setup here. This is a public grill at a boat ramp here in Kentucky. This is the Martha Wayne Collins. Y'all already know where it is. We got our charcoal in here getting hot and burning. We got the fish over here on the thing that we bought from the dollar store. Cheaper than tenfold. And get them on here. They should be good. We got them on the fire. We're gonna let them cook for about 10 minutes or something because we really didn't give them enough time to thaw out all the way, so they still kind of froze. Good hot fire, it shouldn't take them long. And we'll start seasoning them. Should be good. Guys, after they start to cook, all them scales and skin come right off of them. That's the best way to do these is to grill them. Everybody they've talked to says that you don't want to fry them because they mush up too bad. But that right there, skins came all the way off him. It's starting to look good. After we get all the skin off of them, we'll start seasoning them up. Let them cook over the seasoning, and they'll be ready. Well guys, all the skin finally peeled off. What it does when it goes to peel, and you can pull it off with your fingers, or you can just scrape it off with a knife. We went ahead and started seasoning them. What kind of seasoning are we using, Ernie?
Lemon and pepper or something.
Lemon and pepper seasoning and some regular salt. And I'm telling you what's the truth, they're looking good. And they smell good too. Shouldn't be too much longer. Well guys, I think we got them done right in the nick of time. Ernie says they're falling apart, they're real good and tender, and we got the rain moving in right now, so he's going to go ahead here and rush to get them in the bowl. We're going to go over here and get under this little picnic shelter.
Take this. Don't drop them or I will kill you.
So there they go. There you are, guys. That's the finished product. They look good. We'll just have to see how they taste. Well, guys, we got them here. They're done. They smell good. We're going to go ahead and get on it here, get our first bite, see how they taste. They're good.
Yeah, they're really good.
A little bony. You gotta pull the bones off and kind of eat around the bones, but I swear, they're good. Guys, I have ate catfish, I have ate bass, I've ate bluegill. This trout right here takes the cake.
By 10,000.
About like 10 million. Oh my God, it's good.
You just gotta pick around the bones, man. Well, this is all we got for you on this, and we're gonna sit here and devour the rest of this.
Every one of our drinks.
It's a little windy, but y'all stay with us, subscribe, and I guess we'll see you in another video.
You didn't think we was gonna sign off like that, did you? Until next time, remember to like, subscribe, and slab 'em.